You look sick.
Meet Kazi Rahman. His dream is to launch Britain's next airline.
Wow, look at that.
He's a Muslim entrepreneur from London's East End.
I sometimes call myself Halal Richard Branson.
He owns a retail business importing perfume from the Middle East and travels extensively around the world and believes the airline industry is in need of an overhaul.
I'm a British citizen, but every time you're passing through airport security, for some reason you just feel like you've done something wrong, although you haven't. It's like everyone's looking at you, it's like, why is he on the plane for? I think it needs to change.
He thinks he's seen a gap in the market. The world's first Sharia-friendly airline.
If we can incorporate a religious culture, it will be a game changer, and I think people will follow us.
So to help him, he's recruited fellow Bangladeshi Abdul Rakib, who is a self-confessed aviation enthusiast.
One click, it opens, tucks away. It looks small, but you can do a lot with this space. Yeah.
And he's also hired John Brayford, a veteran aviation consultant who knows just how averse to change the airline industry is.
It's not easy to be a renegade in a business which is highly traditional and highly regulated.
Do I make it all halal friendly? Do I stop the booze? Do I do this? Am I going to get the customer?
We want to... alcohol consumption. It's not ethical. If you want to get there, I'm afraid, my man, there is no compromise.
When the money is tight and you've got to compromise, how do you make it work?
It's going on and on and on and on, and it's costing me money every day.
You live in my country, what? You live in my country.
Fuck you!
And when you think the whole world is against you, is it possible to make your dreams come true?
And my conclusion is, Qantas Airways is a disaster waiting to happen. Mate,
is there a halal breakfast option?
No, we are in lunchtime now.
Have a lovely day.
Kazi Rahman's family moved to the UK from Bangladesh in 1997 when he was 13 years old. He left school with one GCSE, and his first job was cleaning the toilets at City Airport.
It was a job where I had to go and clean toilets. Bog drops, the whole lot. I took that job. I was very excited. I could remember on the actual interview, I turned up wearing a suit because that's how serious I was about getting the job.
He was saving to start his first business, and with £600 in his pocket, he set up Sunna Musk Perfumes. Kazi and his brothers have since opened 4 shops across London.
We come from a country that doesn't have much opportunities, and when you see those opportunities in this country, it's like you just want to grab it. But we've grown so fast, it's time for me to kind of explore my real passion. When I see a plane, I get all excited. Yeah, I get very excited. You can see me smiling now. You know, thinking about it, you know, it actually makes me happy. I realized my passion when I saw a plane for the first time in my life. My father was going from UK to Bangladesh, and I saw it, and I was like, wow. It was nighttime, and the lights were flashing like this, and it was fascinating. 1, 2, hello, 1, 2. Can you hear me?
Over the last 2.5 years, Kazi has been trying to launch Firnas Airways, which he hopes will be Britain's 3rd long-haul, full-service airline.
This is not just another tin can airline, ladies and gentlemen. Our aim is for Firnas Airways to become the impetus for change.
He's been holding a number of local community gatherings to test out his idea and to raise funds with the help of self-confessed aviation fanatic Abdul Rakib, who's been with the company from the very beginning, often working for free.
Firstly, we looked at all the destinations that are not served. Places like Tehran, Islamabad. We'd even go to Mogadishu. We don't mind. We'd take the chance and fly there and provide a service.
As a devout Muslim, Kazi wants Firnas to be Sharia compliant.
Well, that is wicked, man.
With modest dress for the crew.
So this skirt maybe can be a bit longer. I would imagine maybe somewhere around here coming down. Or it could be a trouser, I mean.
Halal food and a zero alcohol policy.
Alcohol-free, non-alcoholic mocktails.
Is it as good as the real thing?
I don't know, because I've never drank.
It's a concern for John Brayford, Firnas Airways accountable manager, and Kazi's chief advisor.
If you look at the airlines around the world that don't serve alcohol, there is not one of them that can actually view itself as successful. So I don't think it's going to be an easy battle for him, but I'm backing him.
He's a very brave man, very high ambitious. He's determined. Maybe a little bit crazy also, craziness, because it's a big, big job.
Thanks for coming. I hope you got your checkbook.
Today, Kazi and Abdul are in Ireland, and they're driving down to the city of Waterford. They're looking for a destination to fly to that's not currently being served by other commercial airlines. Finding an unserved route could kickstart Kazi's flying dreams.
His dream is the ultimate, which is to fly long haul. And the entry level there is far, far beyond the means that he has got. And there are a number of routes that have been abandoned by major players because they just don't produce enough profit for airlines to satisfy their shareholders.
So before he can fly long haul, Kazi needs to break into the short haul market. And Waterford Airport is looking for a new operator.
We were told about this opportunity, and then we were like, where is Waterford? Never heard of it. Is it Watford, you mean? There's hundreds of thousands of people living in this area. But if you want to go to Cork, it's 2 hours. Dublin, another 2 hours. You know, it's not good. You know, the connectivity is bad, and we are going to change this. We've met the airport guys, and, you know, for us, it's the perfect match. You know, we're looking for these kind of routes, and they're offering these routes, and, you know, it's a happy marriage.
So it seems there's a window of opportunity. But what kind of aircraft will they need to service the route? With their first destination in the planning stages, they've decided to jump in at the deep end and start shopping for planes.
One click, it opens, tucks away. These actually haven't got much space, but it's the design of these seats, they kind of curve in here, which creates...
This will be Kazi's first major investment.
Can you hear that airplane?
Yeah.
Do you know what aircraft that is? It's our RJ-100. Just took off from City Airport. I can tell some aircraft by the sound of the engines.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
So he's asked Abdul, with his technical experience, to source an aircraft that can service this new, unserved route.
We're here to visit Nordic Aviation Capital. It's a leasing company that specializes in turboprop aircraft.
This is an ATR 72-seater turboprop, ideal for short-haul flights. A lease deal will cost Kazi a cool £1 million.
I feel like getting a sponge now and just polishing it up. Because I'm used to doing it. I'll show you what I used to do in my previous job. As an aircraft cleaner, part of my job was to do the bog drops. I think I'm gonna write a book from airline cleaner to airline owner. Yeah, it's working fine.
Kazi will need to spend £60,000 a month to lease this aircraft.
We're very close. But I know the coming few months are going to be crazy.
It's a huge gamble without the route finalized, but he's keen to push on and prove that he has the vision to carry out his plan.
We just paid the deposit and they deliver the aircraft and, hey presto, we go flying.
Things are moving fast, and John Brayford is worried that Kazi is starting to run before he can walk.
There you go, this is an interesting one. An old BA first-class mug. I keep getting on at him about whether he's making the right moves, whether, you know, that he's not proven himself yet in the businesses that he's in. He is successful, but he's not the ultimate success in the perfume retail business. He's not made a fortune in it, and to risk all that in aviation, to my mind, could border on being foolhardy. But I'm enjoying every minute of working with Kazi. Now, here we are at this point. He's got to sign a document which effectively commits the purchase of an aircraft. Once he's signed the lease, that's the point of no return for him, because his reputation then is completely at stake.
From his lockup in Bethnal Green, Kazi is contemplating this giant leap into the unknown. Whew.
Should I pause it a bit and just speak to my mum or something? I don't know.
How much money is on the table with this contract?
In excess of a million. It's either the best decision of my life or the worst.
This could go wrong.
I lose everything. Everything that I have, everything that I've worked for. On top of that, if you have to face embarrassment.
Are you sure you made the right decision?
I hope I did. I pray to God I did. I'll tell you one thing for sure, though. There is no going back. That is it.
To an Atoll protected holiday now for just a £60 deposit. Jet2 Holidays, package holidays you can trust.
It's one whole year of films with Meerkat movies. 1 month, 4 seasons, the deal is all year long.
Oh, it's a musical. I hate musicals.
A whole year of two-for-one cinema tickets only for customers of Compare Market. Simples.
Alice's mother died just recently, and she was 91. Whether she was at home or indeed later on in a care home, we always made sure that we made video calls. So if we were away on holiday, to be able to show her where we were staying, she said, oh, I feel as if I'm with you. It really did make us feel incredibly close.
BT, we help you be there.
Tell me how do I feel? Tell me now how do I feel?
New BT Plus, our best connection in and out the home. BT, be there.
It starts with a steak, a sprinkling of crispy onions for a sizzling sandwich that'll impress Dad. It starts with Asda, an Aberdeen Angus steak, now just £4.49.
It's about the nostalgia, innit? That's why we come here.
What I did was right.
All I had to do was just be normal.
I want the chopper, I want dogs, and I want them now.
This crime against humanity must never be forgotten.
Acclaimed drama box sets, all free on All4.
The Mitsubishi ASX SUV, absorbing life with documentaries on 4.
Kazi Rahman has signed a £1 million contract for his first aircraft, and he's negotiating the destination for his maiden short-haul route. He's beginning to attract attention in the right circles, and he's even been awarded Entrepreneur of the Year at the British Muslim Awards.
I'm really humbled, actually. I'm not really a public person. I usually like to stay behind the scenes and do great things.
Also working in the background is John Brayford, Kazi's advisor, an old-school aviation expert who is under no illusion about how expensive this will get.
However much money you imagine that you would need, you will always need more. And I keep saying to him that when you think you've got enough money, you have not got enough money. You've got nothing like enough money. And so he could quite easily lose his house and his future and his business in trying to chase a dream.
No, he was asking about how much money I've got in my bank account.
One way Kazi is hoping to finance the launch is through crowdfunding. He's trying to raise £500,000 from individuals who can read his business plan online and invest for a share in the company.
I keep saying this all the time. I have access to enough money to launch this airline. Yeah. It doesn't have to be sitting in my bank account. It could be sitting in another bank account, or it could be sitting in another person's bank account, but it is there.
You do not need millions to start an airline. You give me £100,000, I'll start you an airline.
Funds are beginning to trickle in, and Kazi is keen to take the next step. He wants to find a UK airport close to London from which he can fly to Waterford.
Today we are going to check out Lyd Ashford Airport and also try and see if we can squeeze some money out of them. Maybe about 250k. And I've tried it with the Waterford Airport and they're actually considering it. Who on earth goes and asks an airport to put money down? It's crazy. Sick.
Lyd Ashford Airport is 37 minutes by train from London. It's the only airport close to the capital that doesn't already operate a commercial airline. And they want one. But Kazi wants to do a deal, so he's trying an unusual approach. He's going to ask the airport for a down payment, whereas normally he would pay the airport. And today, he's brought along his brother, Abid.
He does have haters. He definitely has haters. But I think he has a lot of supporters as well. My friends end up calling me like a baller and stuff like that. Like, oh, you're opening an airline, you got planes and this and that. You guys are killing it.
Hello, assalamu
alaikum. Hello, guys. Welcome to the airport.
Thank
you. How are you feeling today?
But if Renas doesn't work out, it could be quite detrimental to our reputation as a family. Because the thing is, with our community, reputation is everything. Obviously, my brothers are imams in various mosques, so that gives a level of trust to people and respect. And they're scared that if he doesn't succeed and he takes people's money, people might think, oh, well, look at his brother. Look what's he done.
Assalamu
This is Annie.
Hi, Annie. How are you?
Wishing everybody a happy Christmas. I will show you the restaurant and see the checking desks as well. We have some visitors today.
Hiya.
Hi, I would like to order a biryani.
No,
I
got
chicken biryani.
No, I got no chop.
Lamb biryani.
No.
Oh, what a shame. Samosas? So tell us, what are you going to give?
Give you what?
If we operate this airport.
Let's first of all get the aircraft, then we can talk about the deal. We're in early stages now, but when you really decide it, then
the
can...
The aircraft is coming in March.
Okay. But I think you have to do your numbers first. You know, aircraft on the ground is always a loss. Yes.
I mean, even if we did have something parked up, we're not going to be paying for it.
So it means I'm not charging you.
So you're not charging me for having the aircraft here?
To tell you frankly, I think they are the beginning of their journey, really.
How do you reckon it went? But he just needs to see the aircraft, then he knows it's serious.
I wish them really the best. And maybe they're only another weakness point that they haven't done it before.
Kazi and Abid leave without the deal they wanted. And their unusual approach to negotiating is a concern for John Brayford.
He can't be too shocking when it comes to meetings with people because they won't take him seriously. You know, it's a different situation than retail. You know, contract negotiations are very serious negotiations where there isn't a great deal of room for being different.
Ooh, looks good.
One area Kazi does believe he can make a difference is in the marketing. And he's keen to get the Fairness brand out there.
If I turned up in my old car, maybe people would just think, is he going to launch an airline? Him? Nah, maybe not. But now, wicked.
He's also using social media to promote the launch, but some of his posts are causing a stir.
Controversy sells. And as soon as you mention the word Muslim, it's like everyone wants to hear, Muslim? So I thought, let me just put this post out. Young Muslim, British Bangladeshi entrepreneur on a mission to launch UK's third long-haul full-service airline. Support him with your likes and comments. All the Muslims are loving it. They're like, yeah, Allahu Akbar. And then on the other hand, you've got the Islamophobic people. No thanks. Risky flying anyway, let alone with a Muslim company. Talk about tempting Allah, I mean fate. Not a chance I would fly with that airline. Kamikaze pilots. The creativity is amazing. But when it comes to these hateful comments, it just makes you think, hang on. I've heard they'll soon provide in-flight female circumcision. What's he on about? I don't know what to make of this. I don't know, man. I really don't know. Like, you know, how can people make comments like this on public domain and social media and still get away with things like this?
And recently, Kazi himself has been the victim of this kind of abuse.
He was like, you want to blow me up? This is what you guys do, don't you? You want to blow me up?
You live in my country, what? You live in my country. Come on, let's go.
It just makes you think about everything, about the whole approach.
Allah.
And we need to do what's good for business. And you know, I think this whole Sharia-friendly thing, branding can't go ahead. It's just not going to work.
This bitter anti-Muslim backlash is a concern to Kazi and Abdul, and they're beginning to reconsider the cultural position of their airline. It's meant the word Sharia is now making them very nervous.
people have this misconception of us being a Sharia-compliant airline. We're not. Okay, let's get that out of the way first.
If someone within the car wanted to fly...
Oh, man, don't do that, please. Don't do that to me.
I just want to know, would, yeah. I want to hear what...
The stress also seems to be taking its toll on their relationship.
I know you're frustrated. Don't take it out.
I'm not taking it out on you. That's your opinion.
It's not just my opinion. It looks shit.
Because of this, you've been brainwashed by the
I haven't been brainwashed.
You're representing Furnas now.
Right, these people will know they can't do all that shit to us.
They'll need to get their story straight because Kazi has been invited up to Wakefield to appear on British Muslim TV. Saba and Sarah on Sisters Hour are keen to know just what Kazi's cultural positioning is with the new airline.
OK, count us down, please, Ryan. It's now time to introduce today's guest. Kazi Shafiq Rahman is an award-winning British Muslim entrepreneur that is launching the UK-based airline Furnas Airways.
Here to tell us more is the man himself, Kazi Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
What was the driving force initially that made you want to kind of market it as Sharia compliant?
This is a question that I get asked a lot. And initially, when we started our journey, we were exploring all kind of ideas, you know, from starting from Sharia friendly to Sharia compliant to halal friendly, all these opportunities. But what we've realized afterwards was the world we live in today, you know, I don't think it's going to work anymore.
Is it not a bit hypocritical if you say you're Muslim friendly and then you don't have
That's why we said we had to change our whole narrative, whole approach.
Islam and Muslim friendly, is that completely out of the equation now?
I don't know. I mean, if it was based in, say, UAE or somewhere else, then you would have made...
Sorry to cut you off. We're just going to go to a quick short break and they'll be carrying on this discussion afterwards. See you soon.
I was a bit taken aback because it was marketed initially as a Sharia-compliant airline, and that was something that, like, made him and his work quite unique. Like Furnas Airways, we try and be Sharia compliant. Is that right?
Yeah, but we don't deviate from being Sharia.
We're not deviating. We're adapting.
They're adapting, Sarah.
I think really it would have been more honourable if he'd stuck to his guns. And I think he could have done Muslims in the UK justice by sticking to the word Sharia compliant and then just explaining it, just saying to people, you know, Sharia actually just means the pathway to Islam. He's really taken a step backwards, actually, and he will then be branded as a hypocrite. That was
actually... Kazi is torn between what seems best for business and his own beliefs. Is trying to please everyone working? And back in London, things have gone from bad to worse.
Just 2 days ago, I got this Entrepreneur of the Year award by Al Rayan Bank. And I was really excited. I was thinking, wow, everything is going, you know, in the right direction. So I just received an email from the CEO of Waterford Airport.
What's he saying?
He's saying that they want to discontinue the discussion with Furnas Airways. We don't want to do business with you anymore.
Who have you told so far?
I'm trying to keep this one quiet. It's quite embarrassing. Obviously, when you wanna get funding and stuff, you can't tell everyone all the problems. You have to show them the good side as well. So I've been showing a lot of good sides to people, and I don't want to show them the problems. Then no one will invest in me. You know these people, they didn't even put my name on this. Anyone could just get hold of one and say, I'm the entrepreneur of the year. We've put so much effort in, you know, to get to where we are, only to hear, like, someone say, oh, we're not interested anymore. I have been dumped.
Jimmy Choo Man Blue, the new fragrance for men.
That's it. You can do it. There you go. There you go.
Come on. You can do it.
You can do it. There we go. There we go.
Do you think you can handle it?
Can't. Can apostrophe T.
You can't get a doll. Just get this one.
Tell me what you think of this.
Hey guys, today I'm doing the finishing touches on the bike.
Can't you just get a real job?
I can't do it.
I got sober.
Mitsubishi ASX SUV, absorbing life with documentaries on 4.
Kazi Rahman's dream of launching an airline has been dealt a major blow. Waterford Airport, their main destination, has pulled out. Without an airport, he's stuck with a very expensive aeroplane and nowhere to fly. He's asked John Brayford to find out what went wrong with Waterford, and it goes back to how Kazi has been negotiating in meetings.
There is doing a deal and street trading. There's market trading mentality. So he then went at a complete oblique tangent and forgot everything he'd ever learned about aviation and said, well, I can offer you shares in the company. Well, if you're a civil servant, you're going to view that as a bribe.
John has called a crisis meeting with Kazi, who, despite the seriousness of the situation, is over an hour late.
It's nothing new. I mean, I've travelled to London and bloody, where are you? And I've already said to him, so he's on final warning from me. This sort of thing pisses me off.
Hello.
Hi, Kazi.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Right, thanks.
They were quite categoric. I mean, first of all, you and Abdul turned up for a meeting and you, how would I say, you didn't look the part.
All of it was Polo Ralph Lauren, actually, but it was more kind of casual.
It was difficult to take you seriously because you knew, you wanted to operate to Waterford and yet you knew nothing about Waterford. So for you to ask for £200,000 deposit, they don't have that sort of money. So the only answer they could ever give was no, and we don't want to ever talk to these people again. Who the hell are they? This is not... This is a... You should recognise this, Kazi. It's a highly regulated business. If you carry on the way you are carrying on, by the time you've learnt, it might be too late. Yeah?
Yeah.
Do I...?
Yes. I understand.
And it is important because people take their lead from their leader. I think he recognises that there were mistakes that were made at Waterford, and those mistakes were baby basic mistakes that he should never have got himself into that position in the first place. The proof of the pudding, of course, is in, does he change his behaviours?
John's honest assessment and advice has made Kazi rethink his approach. He's had to cancel the lease on the turboprop, so now he's back to square one. And Abdul is having to work night shifts as a cab driver, as he's currently not being paid.
I had to join Uber, because currently I'm not getting anything out of Finnair Airways. It's hard financially.
Do you ever chat to your passengers about what you're doing?
I don't. You know why? It's kind of hard. They think, what an asswipe. His cabin and he thinks he's going to start an airline. Shafiq is not really happy about this and he does get frustrated, and I do understand his frustration. I hope he understands my situation. Sometimes it feels like it doesn't.
And Kazi hasn't seen his family for 6 weeks. To let him concentrate on the business, they're spending some time in Bangladesh. Confused and isolated, he's decided to take some time off himself and join them. Kazi has come to Bangladesh to spend more time with his wife and daughter. But there's another reason. He hasn't told anyone yet that he fears his airline is about to fail.
I feel a bit lost. Because I've been on this project for like so long and nothing's happening. I went somewhere yesterday. And the guy was like, oh, yeah, it's a flop. We knew it was a flop. I look scary, by the way. Oh. All the effort, all the money, all the time, all these sleepless nights.
Kazi's birthplace sits in the foothills of Atgram. The region of Zokiganj is a million miles away from Bethnal Green.
I could clearly remember we never had any electric. We never had running water. We would have to go to the pond and, you know, have the shower in the pond. This is my cousin brother. He's having a public shower. My father didn't have like, 2 taka, that's like less than 2p. This is the kind of background we're coming from. God has changed everything around for us. And it all started with being able to go to UK. If we didn't have the opportunity, then I probably would have been, I don't know, driving a rickshaw. We can never ever forget where we come from and who we were. And I seek refuge from God, that I stay sincere and I stay humble.
Kazi might have to accept that not everything is within his control. With such little financial backing, is it really possible to launch an airline? And before leaving for London, Kazi wants to speak to his family.
There has been some changes. You know how it is. One thing changes, something else has to change with it. And I think we need to, like, you know, put a hold to this.
Right. It's a bit of a sticky situation.
It is proper.
I think you should take a step back and really think, is it feasible or is it possible? Because it's looking like it's not happening.
You're not opening a sweet shop, you know, you're not doing Sunnah Mosque all over again. This is like one of the biggest industries you can go into. Even if you start small, I think it's better if you start small and work your way up.
Why didn't you tell me all this before?
I didn't want to give you the headache, like, you know, throw bad news in the works. I know my wife is supportive and she has always been. She's always been a believer. And end of the day, if you ask me, so what are you gonna get out of this? It would be like, you know, I wanna give my daughter a better life, my wife a better life, my whole family a better life. I don't know what's future holding for me. If God has decided that I shouldn't be doing this, then, you know, I'll just have to accept it and live with it and maybe just move on with other things. But God also said you should try. You shouldn't just sit on your bum and just expect dreams to come true.
Having consulted his family, Kazi is back in the UK with renewed vigour. He's decided to downsize his dream. And with cash running out, it's left John Brayford with no option but to rethink the strategy.
We've looked at the economics and the cost of entry for the ATR operation. And frankly speaking, it's too expensive.
The key to Kazi's success in the long run is proving to the UK Civil Aviation Authority that he can run an airline. And it only takes one plane to prove this. So today, he's being shown a much smaller 19-seater British-made Jetstream.
So, what do you think of it?
You can stand up in it.
Well, I mean, it's air-conditioned, pressurised cabin, standing room.
It's something we were looking for and looks like it's in good nick.
Well...
I'd possibly get the interior panels repainted.
Yeah.
Leather redone. Some of these seats...
Yeah. Kazi seems underwhelmed.
That whole day, is that meant to be there, or is that like a...
This is a far cry from what Firnas was meant to be.
This is not the plan, though. How long is it going to take for us to find out what it's going to take us to, you know, to get to where we want to go? Because we're losing too much time.
And we can.
This is going to take us back 2 months now.
Be a bit more patient and let's see where it can get us.
It's like every decision we make, we have to go back right
this
to the bottom.
This is the
and
difference.
Then we come to the peak, and then we say, oh, no, this is not going to work. Let's go and do this. And then it's going on and on and on and on, and it's costing me money every day.
Money is a concern, right? And you're not an industry expert. So you look at opportunities.
Yeah? I don't know, UK, man. I don't know. If you guys can tell me... By this day, we'll know everything about what's required and what needs. Then maybe we can wait for a week.
You have to be very clear on what you want, right?
I know what I want.
No, you don't.
Operating this type of aircraft for short commuter hops might give a much-needed boost to Kazi's funding. And the owner, John Ibbotson, is also the pilot.
You know what it is? It's Jetstream 31.
Yeah.
Built in the late 80s.
She's a good old English aeroplane. It's a turboprop. You need to start somewhere, you need to cut your teeth, and the Jetstream 31 is a very good route prover.
Starting his airline with just one little plane might be his only option.
There's nothing stopping the enthusiasm that you've got in developing into a full-blooded airline. But you've got to live and die it.
So can some old-fashioned British engineering help Kazi finally get his dream back on track?
It is a stark choice that he has to make, that if he wants to get in now, which is what he wants to do, then this is the only effective way of flying passengers.
It's been 8 months, and it seems this is his last chance. So he's decided there's no going back. He fast-tracks a deal with the pilot, John Ibbotson. Kazi wants to refit the plane quickly to show off to his investors in a launch event to raise much-needed cash. But this plane hasn't flown in 2 years, and Kazi is now thinking of bringing back some Sharia-compliant services.
Feels good. Look, we've got it.
The sun's UV rays affect your skin. With a UV camera, you can see it. It also shows how Nivea Sun helps protect skin from UV. That's why Nivea Sun has teamed up with Cancer Research UK to say cover up, aim for shade, and apply Nivea Sun. Trust the UK's number one sun care brand.
Go and see a film with Meerkat Movies. It's one whole year of films with Meerkat Movies. 1 month, 4 seasons, the deal is all year long.
Oh, it's a musical. I hate musicals.
A whole year of 2-for-1 cinema tickets only for customers of Compare the Market. Simples.
Bang, bang, into the room. I know you want it to work.
Mitsubishi ASX SUV, absorbing life with documentaries on 4.
Kazi's airline ambitions have finally been brought back down to earth. He wanted to fly long haul to the Middle East, and now he's been pegged back and bought himself a 19-seater British-made Jetstream.
They don't make them like this anymore, people will tell you. I'm hoping Kazi and Furniss Airways are going to take good care of her.
And if he wants to succeed on a limited budget, this is the only option left.
Those aircraft are as good as the aircraft that we're going to get.
And now Abdul, Kazi's faithful second-in-command, has fallen out with Kazi.
Because of various reasons, I was literally bumped from the executive team. I was sidelined.
And tensions are mounting.
In the same area.
After his swift departure, Abdul has gone public on social media.
Furniss Airways is a disaster waiting to happen. If Kazi thinks he can run an airline with 250k GBP from crowdfunding, then he should be renamed Del Boy Trotter.
But Kazi is forging on, and the plan now is to refit the plane so he can show it to potential investors and fly it for the first time in Furniss colours. As they prepare the plane for the investor launch, Kazi wants to test out the one remaining Sharia-compliant service. How to get round a ban on alcohol.
You know, we're asking people, would you be happy with a mocktail instead of an alcoholic drink on a flight? If it came to a position where it was like, you know, you either launch this airline with alcohol or you don't launch at all. If those were two options given to me, I'll say, you know what? I'll give up on my plans and my dreams and my ambitions, and I wouldn't do it. Irish cream, free man. Oh, alcohol-free drink. No. No. That's a no.
If you ask me if I'm going to fly on an airline without alcohol, that's a no.
Once I swapped my blanket for more alcohol on the flight.
It tastes like Bailey's. It's good. Oh, it tastes nice. Try it.
Yeah.
Got you there.
Yeah, that's nice. That's nice.
Is it free?
Yeah, yeah, you take it. It's for you, man.
Thank you. We don't need to drink alcohol on the plane. We need to stay, keep our heads clear and sensible. The people have a hard job as it is flying us through the air.
I'll fly with you.
Yeah, wicked.
Non-alcoholic drinks, that's all you need, mate, huh?
I mean, I really like the mojito, so I would say yes. It's
yeah?
Really
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah,
Kazi's proved his point. Not everyone wants to drink alcohol while they're flying.
9, 10, 11, 12. 83 against 12. Look. Like, this is not us saying anymore. It's the public, the potential passengers.
As work progresses on the refit, Kazi wants to show off the plane to his investors. So he's planned a launch, which is now just days away. He's decided to take his family to see if the new livery has been finished.
Today is a very, very, very big moment. Very big day for me. And people have said to me, you know, you don't have a plane, but you have a car. What's going on? But now, I've got a plane and I've got the car.
What are you saying? This is looking mad.
It may only be one plane, but he hopes it's the first of many.
I would love to be sat somewhere with him one day and saying, we've got them long-haul aircraft and we've proved everybody wrong. Even Branson started off with one aircraft originally and look at him now. Come on, you know, I know he can't have a beer, but I'll have a beer and he can have a glass of water.
Guys!
Kazi's not looking to create something fundamentally different in aviation. What he's saying is that he believes that aviation in many respects has lost its soul.
It's a moment that I've always been anticipating with great passion. Seeing them run around and enjoy themselves and, you know, it was really a very happy moment for me.
With final checks being made to the jet stream by John Ibbotson, this plucky little plane may be about to fly for the first time in Firnas colours. Today, Kazi has assembled a group of high-net-worth individuals who might invest in his crowdfunding scheme, although it's a day tinged with sadness, as Abdul, his right-hand man, isn't here to see the plane in all its glory.
It came to a point with Brother Abdul. You know, our vision wasn't aligning anymore. We were not on the same page. I miss him, I like him, I love him as a brother. And, you know, it's sad. And I hope, you know, we would still remain friends anyway.
Nevertheless, there are still some big deals to be done. And these investors are treating today as Kazi's final test.
I'm here to see the new airline. The concept is very, very good.
Yeah, impressive. He's got a lot of competition, as we know, but I haven't in detail looked at the business plan and the model.
He is totally committed. And I think, you know, that, if anything, that is the proof of, you know, somebody who should reach success, is they believe in something, they believe in themselves.
With the plane ready, Kazi is now going to invite his guests to fly as passengers on Firnas Airways' maiden flight.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome aboard this Firnas flight. It is a bit choppy. It's very windy. Don't blame the new airline. OK, thanks for your attention.
Thank you. Jesus, I didn't make it.
People of Britain, rules to become successful. First of all, you need to condition your brain up here to be able to attract success. Rule number two, perseverance, mate. You can't give up. And rule number three, focus, focus, focus. Remain like a laser. Every day I'm hustling, 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 hustling.